FranLab.
Hey, it's Fran. Again, at the bench with this little guy. This is my old blood pressure monitor, the wrist type. It's just gotten too old. It started, you know, putting out some crazy numbers that were just not believable. I think, honestly, these things have a definite lifespan, and this is probably at least a decade old, so it's probably like 5 years past its lifespan. I imagine that there's bladders and rubber parts and diaphragms and stuff like that that, you know, are calibrated at the factory, and then over time just they get out of calibration and you just simply have to replace it, which I have done. I've gotten a new one. But I thought it would be a pretty cool idea to tear this one down because I'm very curious to see what's inside. You know, these are ultra miniature, and I would expect, you know, probably a chip on board is what I'd expect to see, you know, just a single chip on a single board. There'd have to be an air pump in there, obviously, and there'd have to be valves to keep air pressure, and there'd have to be a pressure sensor. It might be all in one unit. I wanted to get it apart, and I looked it over, and there aren't any fasteners, so it's probably snapped together. And the top, it feels, it kind of has that feel of a part that's just kind of snapped on the top. So I think I can, if I get under there, I might be able to just pop it off. Trusty chisel. And people who do woodwork always complain when I use a chisel to do this work, and it's like, no, this is my prying chisel. I have very fine wood chisels at the wood shop that I do not do this with, but it's always good to have a very sturdy prying chisel just for doing stuff like this. Yeah. Definitely feels like a fastener. So how would they have done that? So I'm gonna see if I can just cut the cuff off. There's the attachment point in there where the cuff goes into the machine. Universal tool. Big Red. Yeah, come on, Big Red. Let's go for it. All right. Perf. It looks like. Ah. Clips. Yep. There. Another clip. Earth. Earth. Tap. Oh, you can do it. Arr. Ah. Woo. Ah. Yeah, it's clipped on there. I guess if you know exactly where to push the clips that are actually hidden, easier to get it off. Ah, there's a screw. Way down inside there. Way down inside. Oh, it never gets old. Okay. There we go. Yeah. Is that it? Just one screw? Oh. Don't see any other screws. There we go. Ah. Now we're in. Yes. Yep. Perf. There's the screen. Some switches there. Carbon two-shot switches there. Just little rubbery switches with a little carbon dot. Interface with those little switch traces on the board. Got a zebra strip. The old zebra strip. All right. And like, yeah, wow, this is cool. Not disappointing at all. That's like, looks like a real bona fide medical device. As Dave Jones would say, like a bought one. Yeah. And yeah, so everything on this side is all on one board. Flip the screen around. Yeah, oh, wow. Well, it's not chip on board like the potted thing like I thought. It's a little bit more sophisticated. Looks like a CM29BZU 0420. Wow, 2004. No, I can't be right. Well, maybe it is. I don't know. This would be a lot older than I thought. I definitely bought it like in 2014 or 15. I'm pretty sure. Could be using an old part, who knows. But there, you got a little shielded area there. Definitely shrinkified. Got the zebra strip on the LCD screen. Like, yeah. And then, here we go. This is where the magic happens. That looks like a little valve there. That's a solenoid. That's probably the relief valve to open and close the whole system, be my guess. Because it holds the pressure, and then it lets the pressure out, and that looks like just a valve. And that's the pump. Yeah, there's only two wires going to that, so that's just on and off. And there's only two wires going to that, so that's on and off too. Three volts DC. So yeah, that's definitely a coil and a valve. So, arf. Yep. Little nozzle there. So yeah, so that's all. That's just that's all that is. It's just a valve. That's got to be pretty handy for something. And this side we got. Rolling pump, yeah. Oh, Japanese patent, U.S. patent, German patent, Okenseiko Company Limited, made in Tokyo, Japan. They glued that down over the label. Yeah, not gonna be able to read the rest of that. That's really cool. Rolling pump. Wow, I can see a little. It's got a little dimple there. Must be for calibration or something. That's a little DC motor. It's just amazing, the miniaturization in this. It really is astounding tech. Yeah. It looks like this comes apart. There you go. That's the inside of the pump. Had some spring clips holding it together. Yeah, it's a little diaphragm pump. Ooh, it's really, 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 really thin diaphragm. Little silicone part there. Yeah, it's stuck in there, but yeah, there, right there. So yeah, I guess that just moves the. I guess there's a little piston action in there. Moving that little diaphragm, that's a very small little volume. I guess the piston action is just, you know, moving that up and down and just drawing air, pumping it out. A little inflator, a little micro inflator. Pretty amazing. A rolling pump. Yeah. All right, well that's good and discombobulated. Thanks for watching. Thanks to all of my patrons down on the Patreon, making all these videos possible, including this miniature teardown, literally. So thank you, thank you, thank you, everybody on Patreon. Yeah, I'll be back doing something else. Won't be destroying something necessarily, but you never know. You never know what I'm going to be doing in the Fran Lab. All right. See you soon. Work.
the lab. Go berserk. In my lab, it's where I work. At the bench again.